Good morning, Year 3. It's time for Lesson 7 of your How to Train a Dragon unit. And our Can I today is, can I plan and write the third part of an opening scene? So today we're going to write the final part of our opening scene, the exciting part where we get to see the dragons. So we're going to complete the following. We're going to do a writing warm-up looking at time conjunctions today. We're going to review and recap the scene. We're going to check our steps to success, and we're going to write our sentences. So have a little think. What are time conjunctions? When do we use them? And can you think of any examples? I'm going to give you 30 seconds to pause the video and have a think. Brilliant. Time conjunctions are words or phrases which are used to tell a reader when something is going to happen. So for example, this morning, the postman came. So the postman came in the morning and it was the morning of today. So this morning. A few moments later, there was a knock on the door. So as they were waiting for something to happen, imminently, something did happen. The postman knocked on the door a few moments later. Suddenly, that's a really quick time conjunction because it happens really quickly. And endless days later, that's what I would call a long time conjunction because it's going to be in the future, a long time in the future. These four time conjunctions we've got here all start the beginning of a sentence, and they should have that comma at the end. So that's a fronted adverbial time conjunction. They have the comma before you start writing your main phrase. So just to remember, time conjunctions are words or phrases which are used to tell a reader when something is happening, and they can help to show the order of events and the pace of the story. So the pace means how quickly something is happening. Have a look at these two conjunctions here. Which one of these time conjunctions shows something is happening quickly? In the blink of an eye or later that day? Point to the screen. Well done. In the blink of an eye. That is a really quick snapshot of what's happening right then. And a blink of an eye is very fast, isn't it? Whereas later that day could be any time from right now until 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock tonight, later that day. Which one of these time conjunctions shows something happening quickly? We've got seconds later, after lunch. Seconds later, well done, fantastic. Here are the two time conjunctions that we've thought of so far. Can you think of any more quick time conjunctions where something is going to happen immediately? So we've got in the blink of an eye and seconds later already. How many more can you think of that means something is going to happen quickly? Give yourselves 30 seconds and write down a few now. Right, let's have a look. I've got suddenly, as quick as a flash, in a flash, a split second later, and before they knew it. So all of those mean that something has happened very quickly. So we're going to call them quick time conjunctions today. And hopefully we'll be able to include some of those in the final part of our writing later. Now, talking about the final part of our writing, let's see what we've got so far. So I've put both days worth of work on one slide here so that I can read through from the very, very beginning. A thick blanket of eerie silver mist hung in the ebony midnight sky. It floated elegantly just above the water and almost entirely obscured the view of the island behind it. In the distance, colossal looming watchtowers guarded a small rickety Viking settlement. Amber fires glowed in their mouths as the raging sea crashed violently against the jagged rocks below. On the hillside, white fluffy sheep stood out like dots on a green canvas as they roamed freely on the wild island. Sturdy wooden huts huddled together on the craggy landscape, and their warm flickering lanterns glowed in the dark night. Outside, unsuspecting innocent sheep grazed happily on the lush green grass. Fantastic. What I'd like you to do now is to read through your 2 days' worth of writing to remind yourself of what you have already written. So pause the video and do that now. Today's writing, we're going to focus on the last three parts of our clip. So one of the sheep is snatched up by a, we don't know what it is yet. We finally see a dragon. And then Hiccup slams the door shut to stop the dragon's fire entering the building. So those are the three scenes that we're going to focus on today. So let's watch carefully and see if you can pick up any words that you might want to use in your description.
This is Burke. It's 12 days north of Hopeless and a few degrees south of freezing to death. It's located solidly on the meridian of misery. My village. In a word, sturdy. And it's been here for 7 generations, but every single building is new. We have fishing, hunting, and a charming view of the sunsets. The only problems are the pests. You see, most places have mice or mosquitoes. We have...
Fantastic. So did you catch that? Don't forget, you can always watch it again to see what happened, so you can get some ideas together. So the clip is always available to watch again. Okay, so before we start our writing, let's have a look at our word bank. What could we use that we've already started previously in the lessons? So the sounds and the settings that we had before, we might have already put in the sounds, dragon wings beat powerfully and villagers shouted. And in the settings section of our planning, we might have written the island was overrun with dragons. So now I've given you some verbs and adverbs to help describe the dragon. So we've got swooped down skillfully, he snatched the sheep quickly, and descended upon the village suddenly. Those phrases could be used in your writing too, don't forget. And you've already got some phrases to help you. And then verbs and adverbs to describe the villagers. The villagers fled to their huts fearfully. They panicked instantly and they scattered, which means they went in all different directions frantically, not really knowing where they were going. So if you'd like any of those phrases and you've got your own or you want to add to your own, please magpie them now. Excellent. So our task is to write at least one sentence for each of these points. The sheep was snatched by a mysterious creature. There was chaos everywhere as everyone tried to flee from the dragons. And number three, that was that after it was revealed that the creatures were dragons and they were the pests of the island. Everybody else might have rats or rabbits or whatever as pests, but this island was unique. It had dragons. So remembering our success for steps for success. When we write, we need to make sure we're including our capital letters, finger spaces, full stops, and we're reading it through to make sure that they are there. When we think of our sentence, we think of it, we say it, we decide whether we want to like it or improve it, we write it down, and then we check that we've actually written the words that we want to read. And then we spend some time to improve it. Today's aims of our lessons is to use those precise adjectives to describe a setting, the precise verbs and adverbs to describe the actions of what's going on, and those time conjunctions that we've just learned to sequence and add detail when things actually happen. So here are my sentences for the first scene, and obviously you can magpie some ideas from them if you wish. Okay, so in a matter of seconds, the innocent sheep was skillfully snatched from the ground by a mysterious beast. And then my second sentence, only the sound of beating wings could be heard as the sheep disappeared completely from where it stood moments before. So in a matter of seconds, there is my quick time conjunction. It happened instantly. And then I've got my comma at the end of my quick time conjunction, my fronted adverbial phrase there, before I start my main phrase. I've got a precise adverb, skillfully. And then in my second sentence, I've used a complex sentence here, and you can see my subordinating conjunction as making my complex sentence. My first sentence was actually just a simple sentence, wasn't it? So my second sentence is a complex sentence using that subordinating conjunction. And I've moved my quick time conjunction to the end of my complex sentence. So where it stood moments before is my second quick time conjunction. Okay, your turn. Don't forget your steps to success, and I'm looking forward to reading what you wrote. So pause the video now, and then we'll move on to the next slide. Well done. Now for this ending piece, I'm going to combine the last two pictures because I think they fit really, really closely together. So we see the dragon and we see Hiccup's reaction to it. So these are my two sentences. Seconds later, there was a great commotion as animals and villagers fled from the terrifying beast. The island was overrun with dragons. So in my first sentence, my time conjunction is at the beginning with my comma. And then it's another as conjunction is creating a complex sentence. Here we go. So we've got as, another as conjunction creating a complex sentence. And then my last sentence includes an exclamation mark to emphasize the drama and the point of the sentence. The point was, we finally realize that these beasts are dragons. Okay, your turn. Pause the video now and write your sentences about these last two pictures. Don't forget to include your time conjunctions. Off you go. Brilliant job, year three. So let's celebrate completing our writing by reading the whole section that we've written together. And then what I'd like you to do is to read your writing on the Seesaw app and record it on the Seesaw app and send it to us so we can hear what you've written, because we need to celebrate this fantastic writing that you're doing. So here is what I've written. A thick blanket of eerie silver mist hung in the ebony midnight sky. It floated elegantly just above the water and almost entirely obscured the view of the island behind it. In the distance, colossal looming watchtowers guarded a small rickety Viking settlement. Amber fires glowed in their mouths as the raging sea crashed violently against the jagged rocks below. On the hillside, white, fluffy sheep stood out like dots on a green canvas as they roamed freely on the wild island. Sturdy wooden huts huddled together on the craggy landscape, and their warm, flickering lanterns glowed in the dark night. Outside, unsuspecting, innocent sheep grazed happily on the lush green grass. In a matter of seconds, the innocent sheep was skillfully snatched from the ground by a mysterious beast. Only the sound of beating wings could be heard as the sheep disappeared completely from where it stood moments before. Seconds later, there was a great commotion as animals and villagers fled from the terrifying beast. The island was overrun with dragons. Fantastic work, year three. Tomorrow, we are going to be working on the build-up of our story. So keep your How to Train a Dragon hats on, and we will start that tomorrow. Well done, year three. You've done a fabulous job, and I can't wait to hear what you have written.